In this video, we will talk about weak duality, strong duality, and how to use duality to solve the dual based on the optimal solution to the primal. These are general primal and dual problems in the standard form. The primal is a maximization problem. The objective function is z. The dual is a minimization problem. The objective function is w. C and B switch places in the primal and dual. The coefficient of the primal becomes the right-hand side of the dual. The right-hand side of the primal becomes the coefficient of the dual. The constraints are less than or equal to in primal, and they are greater than or equal to in the dual. The coefficient Aij becomes Aji. With this in mind, now let's introduce the weak duality theorem. Let x, x1 through xn, be any feasible solution to the primal problem. Let u, u1 through um, be any feasible solution to the dual problem. The weak duality theorem says that the z value for x in the primal is always less than or equal to the w value for u in the dual. Let's check an example. This is the primal, and this is the dual. For the primal, let's check this point, 5, 2, is a feasible solution because it satisfies all the constraints. We plug these values into the objective function and z is equal to 350. For the dual, let's check this point, 0, 10, 0. It's a feasible solution because it satisfies all the constraints. We plug in these values into the objective function and w is equal to 400. In this example, z is less than or equal to w. We can also check other feasible solutions to the primal and dual. They should all follow this rule. Now let's introduce the strong duality lemma. Let x, x1 through xn, be any feasible solution to the primal problem. Let u, u1 through um, be any feasible solution to the dual problem. The strong duality lemma says that if the z value for x in the primal is equal to the w value for u in the dual, then x is the optimal solution to the primal and u is the optimal solution to the dual. Let's check this example again. This is the primal problem and this is the dual. For the primal, the optimal solution is this point, 3, 2.8. We plug these values into the objective function, and z star is equal to 370. For the dual, the optimal solution is this point, 0, 10, 10. We plug these values into the objective function, and w star is equal to 370. In this example, z star is equal to w star. We can also check the primal and dual of other linear programming problem examples. They should all follow this rule. Now let me explain the graphical meaning of the weak duality theorem and the strong duality lemma. Let's consider this vertical axis. It increases from minus infinity to positive infinity. For the primal problem, we want to maximize z. The initial basic feasible solution may give us a very small z1. For example, it is located here. After the first simplex iteration, we find a better basic feasible solution with the larger value z2 here. After many iterations, we finally found the optimal solution, which gives us the max value z star here. We cannot go above this point. For the dual problem, we want to minimize w. The initial basic feasible solution might give us w1. It is very large. For example, it is located here. After the first dual simplex iteration, we find a better basic feasible solution with a smaller value w2 here. After many iterations, we finally found the optimal solution, which gives us the minimum value w star here. We cannot go below this point. The strong duality lemma says z star must be equal to w star. This is the graphical meaning. So based on this graphical explanation, we can also derive these two lemmas. If the primal is unbounded, then z star is infinitely large. So is w star. so the dual is infeasible. If the dual is unbounded, then W star is infinitely small. So is Z star. So the primal is infeasible. Based on the weak duality theorem and the strong duality lemma, we can derive this strong duality theorem. Suppose BV is an optimal basis for the primal, then we can use this formula, U is equal to CBV times B inverse to calculate the optimal solution to the dual. Also, Z star is equal to W star. CBV is the vector of the initial objective function coefficients for the optimal tableau's basic variables. B is a matrix whose j's column is a column for Bj in the constraints of the initial canonical form. Let's check this example. It is a maximization problem with three inequality constraints. We introduce three slack variables and write out the initial simplex tableau. We also use the simplex method and found that this is the optimal tableau. Now in the optimal tableau, the basic variables are S1, X3, and X1. The coefficients of these three basic variables in the initial objective function are 0, 20, and 60, respectively. B is a matrix. Its first column is a column for S1 in the constraints of the initial canonical form. Its second column is a column for X3 in the constraints. And its third column is a column for x1 in the constraints. Then we can use this formula, U is equal to CBV times B inverse to calculate the optimal solution to the dual. Finally, we have U1, U2, U3 are 0, 10, and 10 respectively. Also, W star is equal to Z star 280. There is actually another way to find the optimal dual solution quickly by reading the optimal primal tableau. If constraint I has a less than or equal to sign in the primal, then the optimal value of the dual variable ui is equal to the coefficient of slack variable si in row 0 of the optimal primal tableau. If constraint I has greater than or equal to sign in the primal, then the optimum value of the dual variable ui is equal to minus coefficient of excess variable ei in row 0 of the optimal primal tableau. If constraint I has an equal sign in the primal, then the optimal value of dual variable ui is equal to coefficient of artificial variable ai in row 0 of the optimal primal tableau minus m. Let's check this example. This is the primal and this is the dual. This is the optimal tableau for the primal. Let's try to find the optimal solution by just observing this optimal primal tableau. The first constraint has a less than or equal to sign in the primal. Then the optimum value of dual variable u1 is equal to the coefficient of slack variable s1 in row 0 of the optimal primal tableau, which is 51 over 23. The second constraint has a greater than or equal to sign in the primal. Then the optimal value of the dual variable u2 is equal to minus coefficient of excess variable e2 in row 0 of the optimal primal tableau, which is minus 58 over 23. The third constraint has an equal sign in the primal. Then the optimal value of the dual variable u3 is equal to coefficient of the artificial variable a3 in row 0 of the optimal primal tableau minus m, which is 9 over 23. Also, W star is equal to Z star, which is 565 over 23. Okay, that's all about weak duality, strong duality, and how to use duality to solve the dual based on the optimal solution to the primal. Thanks for watching.